So in Keynote, if you want to have a slide that builds element by element as you talk about the things on the slide, you would have different objects there. But you could also do the same with a bullet list. You can have a single bullet list and it build line by line. So here all I did was created a new slide and I used the title and bullets template there for the slide. So I just have a title and then I put 9 lines here. And if I were to hit play, the entire thing builds at once. But say I want to talk about each item, so I want it to pause after each one. What I can do here is I can go to Animate and I can add a built-in effect. So I click Build In and I go to Add an Effect. So I'll use Move In as an example here. And you can see now that everything moves in at once. So I hit Play, it starts showing me the title, and then when I click, everything moves in at once. Now what if I wanted them to move in one at a time? Well, I could do that here with this bullet list by going to Delivery, and you can see it says All at Once. I can change that to By Bullet. So when I change to By Bullet, I get some options here. Build from first to last. I can change that, say if I wanted to start with the fourth item or something like that, or only build to the seventh item. But in most cases, first to last. Now when I hit Play, you can see nothing's there. I click and it builds the first item. Click again, it builds a second, etc. So now I can talk about each item as it appears on the screen. So you can see why you would want to have it set to 2, because I can hit play and the first item is already there. Sometimes that is what you want. Now I can alter this a little bit here. I can go and click on the build order and you can see all of the different items here. The 9 different items in the list. And I can select one and I can see here it starts on click. But say if I wanted to group them together, I could say let's have the second one here go right after build one. Let's do that for the third one and the fourth one as well. I could also drag and drop. So I can take this item here and drag it in there and it's the same thing. So I'm going to group together the first 4, the next 4, so like the inner planets, the outer planets, and then Pluto by itself. And then when I hit play, look what happens. I click and each item still builds, but it's doing it automatically. I clicked once and the first 4 appear. I can do it again and the next 4 appear. And then again in the last one in a group by itself. So you can group them together, although they will still animate separately. So what if I wanted them to all come in at once? Well, there's no real good way to do that, but there is a workaround. So you can see there's by bullet group. Well, by bullet group really doesn't change anything because each one of these is its own bullet group. If I were to go into the text here and indent these here to make this a group and this to make this a group, then it kind of works like what I want. Let me go back in here and I want to change it so that everything is on click. So now each of these 3 groups will appear on click. Now I get what I want, except the indent is wrong. Right? I don't want Venus, Earth, and Mars to be indented under Mercury. I want them to be equal to it. So I can kind of do a workaround there by going in the text here, selecting all, and I'm going to go to Format, and then I'm going to go to Text Bullets here, and I'm going to just select these items here, and I want to change the indent to 0. And now basically, even though they're technically a subheading, there is no horizontal difference. So the Venus, Earth, and Mars lines are actually indented under Mercury, but indented by 0 points. So now it actually works like what I want. And that works out really nicely. So that's one advantage there. Now there is another thing you could do here. Let me go and undo that by quite a bit and get all the way back to where each thing was individual. So each one's by itself. Now what's nice if you're going to talk about each one is to actually change it under Build In to by highlighted bullet. Here's what highlighted bullet looks like. First one looks normal. Second one comes in and you can see it highlights the current bullet and it dims the other one. So now you get this nice effect where it's obvious about what it is you're talking about at this point. and the other ones are dimmed. So there's some options there for creating cool animated builds using only a bullet list in Keynote.